Hello everyone, today I wanted to talk to you a little bit about finishing your basement and what we look for when we're in a new basement finish. We're in the mechanical room, and one thing that's important to look at is the electrical panel. So what we're trying to determine when we're looking at the panel is, are we going to need to have an additional subpanel added to the existing panel? So for this house, we have one available, two available openings, and that is not enough to run a full basement. But some houses have, you know, 10 or so empty slots, and it's a good question, do we have enough space in there to install all the breakers for the basement? So what we do when we're doing that is, the first step is to have an electrical design completed with all the outlets and the lights shown on there so that you can count up how many outlets you have, how many lights you have. And then what we figure on is 9 openings per 15 amp breaker, and lights count as a half an opening. And then that will get you covered for all the general outlets and lighting in the general square footage of the living space of the basement. Moving on from there, we need to look at the kitchen and the laundry room and the bathroom, if those rooms are going to be part of the basement finish. So by code, kitchens have to have 2 20 amp breakers for your small appliances, for, you know, waffle makers and things like that. And then typically in reality, a lot of kitchens need more than that though. So they're gonna have those 2 for the small appliances. Then we're going to have 1 for the fridge, 1 for the microwave, and then another 1 for the stove. If it's a gas stove, we can just put on a 20 amp circuit. So that will really make the kitchen a lot nicer, so you're never tripping breakers or anything in the kitchen. So we plan on about 5 for the kitchen. Code minimum is 2. And then for the laundry room, if it's a gas dryer, we don't need to worry about this. We can just put it on a 20 amp circuit so that it has enough for the starter to ignite the gas and run the motor. If it's electric, we need to have at least a 30 amp breaker. It looks like this, and so it takes up 2 spots in the panel. And then for the kitchen, if it's a electric stove, we're going to need to have a 40 amp circuit there, so that takes up 2 more spaces. So once we get all that figured out, then we have a really good idea of how many bays in the panel we're going to need to occupy. And if we have enough here, then we can just use what's already here. If not, then we add another panel, so we have a whole bunch of slots over there we can put more breakers. So if you need help finishing your basement, we'd love to talk to you. You can reach out to us on our website, danzydesignbuild.com. We have cost guides and cost calculators for basement finishing and also for home remodeling. So head on over to our website, and we'd love to chat with you. Thanks. Have a great day.